We've all been there, sitting on a Zoom call trying to figure out why you can't get audio while Mark from accounting has a super professional broadcast going off. Here's a few simple tips that you can do to take your Zoom game to over 9,000. This is DIY in 5. Hey everyone, welcome to DIY in 5, the show where we make tech so easy that you can DIY it all in under 5 minutes. Approximately. Today we're going to go over some of our favorite Zoom tips and tricks included in the latest 2021 updates that will up your Zoom game tremendously, whether it's for work, school, or virtual game nights. Having that sweet tavern background on your virtual D&D game without your dog barking in the background makes a big difference. If you find the tips in today's video useful, please give this video a like, share it with friends, hit that bell, and subscribe so that you don't miss out on any future tech tips. Roll for initiative, and let's do this. First, you'll want to make sure Zoom is updated to the latest version. At the time of recording this video, that is version 5.5.4. You can do this by clicking your photo in the top right corner of your Zoom window and mousing down to check for updates, and Zoom will do the rest for you. All of the tricks that we'll discuss today work with this latest edition and a basic, aka free, Zoom account. There are some more shinies included with the pro account, but we'll save those tips for another time. Today, everyone can get in on the action. First up, let's chat audio. Bad audio in a Zoom meeting is probably the biggest deal breaker there is. If you can't hear or be heard, all bets are off. The latest update to Zoom brought in two features that will make your voice come through like a professional broadcast, even if you don't have a professional streaming or broadcast studio at your disposal. The first is an option to suppress background noise without buying a fancy microphone. Many higher-end microphones will have features to help with this, but now it's built right into Zoom. Simply go into your audio settings and about halfway down the page, you'll see options to suppress background noise, depending how much background noise you are dealing with. From distant outdoor traffic to loud typing or dogs barking in the same room as you. If you're unsure, there's an auto setting that will do its best to tune it out for you. Now, for folks using Zoom specifically for music, this may sound like a nightmare, but Zoom has also added a professional music mode, which gives you an in-meeting option to turn on original sound. This option automatically disables Zoom noise suppression, removes automatic gain control and high pass filtering, and is really best for folks using more professional audio equipment specifically for recording or music purposes. Okay, next, let's chat video tips. Many of us have probably played around with virtual backgrounds at some point, you know, making it seem like you're in space or at that medieval tavern that I mentioned earlier. This is good fun, but doesn't have the same effect if your actual person still looks like you just fought a bugbear. You can now touch up your appearance and adjust for low light in room, both on a sliding scale. Early morning, haven't had coffee? No problem. Lighting is crud where you are. No problem. Both of these can be toggled off or on and adjusted in video settings under the My Video section. If you want to go even farther, Zoom now offers video filters as well, allowing you to add hats, borders, artistic photo effects, and more. And if you want to go even farther, the studio effects option in the lower right will let you add eyebrows, facial hair, lipstick, etc., and is a real hoot. If you love the new look that you've created, you can even check the box to set it for all future streams. Hard note there. Finally, let's talk about tips to maximize your experience when Zooming with others. If you are all too familiar with having to swap pages in gallery view to see everyone, teachers with large classes, I'm looking at you, you'll be happy to know that you can now set your Zoom to show 49 participants in gallery view instead of 25, with just a quick toggle in video settings. Yes, everyone's screen is smaller, but the overview is very nice if you need that. If you're sharing a screen with everyone on your call, you now have the option to use a PowerPoint as your virtual background, putting your face over top your presentation so viewers can watch both at the same time. Simply click the Share Screen button located in your meeting controls. Navigate to Advanced at the top and click Slides as a virtual background and choose a PowerPoint file. You can then move your image around to wherever you'd like on top of the PowerPoint while presenting. Let's say it's not a PowerPoint type of Zoom, it's a virtual game night and you want to share multiple on-screen windows. Rather than swapping back and forth or sharing your entire desktop, you can now go to screen sharing and choose multiple windows at the same time. Sweet. Speaking of multiples sharing at the same time, you can now have two different participants share their screens at the same time as well, rather than having to change who the host is in order to share. As the meeting host, you can choose to allow multiple people to screen share simultaneously, and viewers can swap between which screen share they would like to see. Even fancier, if a participant has a dual monitor setup and wants to watch both at the same time, they can do that as well via the Use Dual Monitors option in General Settings. Again, assuming most of us do not have a home broadcast quality studio wherever we are, it's really nice that Zoom has incorporated a lot of these things from a software perspective on their side. And knowing these simple free tips can take you from level 1 bandit to level 14 barbarian, respectively, with just a few settings tweaks. If you have any specific Zoom troubles that you would like the Hive Mind here at Kingston to help out with, make sure to put them in the comments and we'll do our best to help each other out. Take care, everyone, and I'll see you next time with more DIY in 5.